sleep?
No.
No? Yes?
Yes. Good. Short, very short, only
very
5
short,
hours.
Yeah.
But
how was last night?
Was brilliant. It was really, really great.
And you?
Kind of, yeah. We had eaten dinner, so we went back to the city center. Didn't get to the restaurant until like 9:30. So, and I was starving, so I ate like 30 cheese biscuits, which didn't feel good at midnight. And then it's 7 hours earlier in Texas, and so I was like, I'll FaceTime Genevieve and the kids and say hi and love you, because we play phone tech kind of during the day. And the kids want to talk, and I'm like, yeah, te amo. Got some rest. I'm excited to be here. I feel better today than I did yesterday. Anyways, I'm not gonna make you guys wait too long. I have my Brazilian friend over here, so let's start this off. Good morning.
Good morning. My friends and I were talking about how passionate you are and how you seem to enjoy every step of the convention, like to really feel the moment and make everyone feel like so special and unique. And I was wondering if you weren't an actor,
weren't,
if you weren't an actor, what do you think you was going to be doing right now?
Thank you for the question. So when I graduated high school in 2000, I was going to go to university in Austin, and my brother is 3 years older than I am. So I'm used to playing a little brother in real life as well. I used it with Sam. But he got a degree in engineering and medicine, so he's a surgeon now. He was always my idol growing up. He was my big brother. I looked up to him. And so I was going to do the same and try and either be a doctor or an engineer. He has both degrees, and I was like, okay, I'll do that. But now where I am, I would have loved to have been a doctor of some sort, but I'm too emotional when things go wrong, and sometimes things just go wrong, so I don't know if I would do well. I love animals, so you're like, oh, I'll be a veterinarian. You're like, well, sometimes you have to put animals down, you know, like, I don't want to do that, and I don't want to be a doctor that has to give bad news. But I think I'd love to be, I mean it, like, you know what I mean? It'd be tough to go like, hey, your arm is broken and we have to cut it off or whatever, you know what I mean? What time is it? Too much wine last night. I think I'd love to be a teacher. Yeah. Cause I love learning. And I feel there's a great quote. I don't know if it's a quote or something I heard, but it's something like, if you haven't learned from somebody you're talking to, then you haven't been listening. You know, everybody is unique, and everybody does have something to offer, and everybody has had a different life, different experiences. And so if you keep your eyes and ears open and listen, like, I learned from my children, you know? And it's weird, but you learn a love of life, an excitement of curiosity and discovery. So I think I wouldn't mind being a teacher, and I don't know what age. Probably not kids, because they're fucking rowdy. Maybe like high school or college, and I could put on those like professor glasses and act handsome. But yeah, so I'll go with that.
Thank you.
Good to see your face again. Thank you. Good morning. Oh, come on.
Listen.
I drink wine less than I also. Good morning.
Good morning. I've got a serious question. I'm sorry, I know it's a
morning. Great, no, let's do it.
How did Supernatural ending affect your day-to-day relationship with Jensen? Because you went from working together every day to not. I know it ended in a pandemic, but how did it affect you and stuff?
Yeah, great question. It didn't really. I mean, even during Supernatural, granted, we spent so much time with each other every day. But if, you know, if he had a week off, he went to see his family. I went to see my family. And we text and we're like, hey, I'm going to dinner. I'm going to watch the game or the UFC fight or something. It's like, oh, I can't make it. Or I can't. I'll see you there. And so it never really changed. And I think it's this far out, 4 years after rapping, it's so weird to think about 15 years. you know, in America, you know, kindergarten is like, I'm sorry, school is like kindergarten, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10th, 11th, 12th. That's when you graduate high school, and then 13th, 14th. And so it's almost like starting with somebody in kindergarten and going all the way through sophomore year in college or university with somebody. But that's the only fucking person you see. You know, it's not like, oh, he's in the class. It's like, oh, I'm staring at his face all the time. And so we'll always have a pretty deep connection. And I was, you know, I was friends with him when he met his wife. He was on set when I met my wife. You know, we flew together when he had his twins. I was on set with him when my first was born, you know. So we have all these milestones that we've shared. And so it's just an easy relationship, you know. Like, if I don't see him for a day, it's like, hey. If I don't see him for a month, it's like, hey. You know, it's not a needy relationship. Like, I'm totally needy with my wife. Like, if I don't talk to her, I'm like, was she mad at me? But with Apple, like, we're just buddies, you know? And I know he's busy. He knows I'm busy. So it's almost like and the way my life is structured, I had a great question. Well, Jensen and I both had a great question yesterday about, like, what's your next goal in life, from my Brazilian friend. And about, like, being better about relationships. My brother, my legit brother I just talked about, he lives a 10-minute drive away. Sometimes we'll see each other 3 times in a week. Our kids will play together and all that. And sometimes I don't see him for 2 months, and he lives 10 minutes away. But it's like, okay, he's a doctor. He has a wife and kids. I'm an actor, a wife and kids. Like, life is busy, but I'm not concerned. You know, it's like, and he's not concerned. So I feel like that's the same. Like, I don't think my time not filming with him now is different than my time not filming with him 4 years ago, 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 100 years ago, however fucking long it was. So yeah, I always, you know, he stood in my wedding, I stood in his, we'll always be connected.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Sarah. And yeah, I'd like to talk about dogs. We know you love your dog so much, and so do I. We've got the German Shepherd, and she's here. I'm not here in the room, but she's here at the convention.
And bring her over here.
Love to introduce her to you so much.
Love
you. She's become part of the family. She's the mascot of the convention. They all know her. We took her to our first convention last June, and well, everyone loves her. And well, she had the time of her life, so we took her back this time. And she even had her own photo op in the hall with everyone. That was so nice. And
post it and tag Jib.
Okay, I will. So I ask everyone to send me their pictures with Gwen. So I'll make.
Yeah, what's your phone number?
We have a group. Okay, WhatsApp group. And so that's great, because she's part of something that is so important for me, okay? And so my question is this: do you have an event or something apart from your, let's say, usual family life, where one of your dogs was involved and you can link that memory to one of them and you were happy that they were part of it or could participate?
I won't meet your dog. Yeah, dogs have been a part of my life for many years. We had a golden retriever growing up, and then when I moved to LA, season 3 of Killing the Girls, so 2003, I rescued a dog, Sadie. A year later, I rescued a dog, Harley. They both passed. But Sadie was with me from 2003 till 2019. She passed away, but I put her out. It was really difficult. Because she, you know, I got her when I was 20 years old, and she lasted until I was, you know, 36, 37 years old. So there were so many life moments to share. But yeah, do we have animal fans out there? Woo! My peeps. Yeah, specifically, I'm not sure. It's just, it's almost like spending time with a friend, you know, who's excited to see you. I heard this. I don't know if y'all have heard this, but have you heard, like, like how old are you in dog years or whatever, like a dog that's 1 year old is kind of like a 7 year old and 2 years, so 7 years. And so I read something one time, like if you don't, when you go to bed at night, if you sleep for 6 hours, if one human year is like 7 dog years, then 6 human hours is like 42 dog hours. So it's like your dog hasn't seen you in 2 days. So you wake up and they're like, where were you? Like I left Thursday with Cliffy. I get back Tuesday. So for me, it's... For me, it's 6 days. For my dogs, it's going to be a month and a half. And I know. Y'all, shall we cry together? Is it that time? I'm here for it. So it kind of makes you appreciate life and time a little bit more. Yeah. It's like every time you go away for... I go to work, you know, I work 12 hours. I'm like, oh, it's half a day. But for my dog, it's like half a week. So, oh, that's why you're so excited. Like, I'm excited to see you too. But yeah, so don't forget that. Anyways, good to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Not blushing.
Not yet. First, I wanted to say that as much as we all love seeing you here, I do.
You want me to leave? Okay.
No!
Stay. Let me finish.
Okay. Now I'm blushing.
So, as much as we all love seeing you here and we are so excited for GIP 15 next year, I do hope that you get every and any project that you would want to get. That being said, my question was about you joked once that the only thing you regret that the weapons didn't evolve through the Supernatural series, and you joked about like putting salt in a hula hoop.
Oh yeah.
Do you know how to hula hoop?
Do I own a hula hoop?
No. Do you know how to hula hoop?
I do know how to. Yeah, I haven't hula hooped in a while.
Do you have a roof?
Oh yeah, yeah. I'll post a video. I think salt in a hula hoop and putting our weapons on a bungee. Been two things that we should have done. Yeah, so we always dropped our weapons. Like, ah, shit. But they came back. Or develop the force and just grab it.
Peanut butter and jelly and like sneakers.
That's not a weapon. Wait, peanut butter and jelly what?
Yeah, because...
That's a sandwich, not a weapon.
Yes, but when you put like peanut butter and then jelly, it always falls on the jelly side, you know? And then there's the sneaker part when...
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. I'm kidding. I'm trying to make you blush. Just kidding. I said I think that might be good. We need salted hula hoops, bungees, and more peanut butter and jelly.
Yeah.
I'll send a video of all three. Of the bungee, hula hoop, peanut butter and jelly. Everybody will throw up. Thank you. Good to see you. Good morning.
I'm Katja from the Netherlands, and my question needs a little introduction.
Okay.
The situation is you've auditioned for and obtained the role of a leading screen queen in the next horror flick.
Leading screen queen?
King.
Screen king, got it. Awesome. All right, cool. You're better at it than I thought.
And the casting director says, okay, you'll meet the... actors playing the root of all evil on the very first day of shooting, which is also immediately the final showdown, the fighting scene.
Okay.
And that day arrives, and then all of a sudden that girl comes on, tucks your shirt and says, "Hi Dad, it's me, Odette. How are you reacting as a dad?"
That's a good question, got it. Odette, y'all know the singer Pink? Obviously, she's super famous. Odette wants to be Pink. So none of our kids expressed an interest in acting. They've come to set a few times, and I'm grateful because it's a crazy life. I've been very blessed, but it's more likely than not a bit of a crazy life. But yeah, she'd be a great arch-villain. She's feisty.
How would you react as a dad?
I'd probably quit. That'd be my official retirement. I'd be like, oh God, like, Odette's been unleashed to the world. It's like, we thought Lilith was dangerous. Wait till you meet Odette. Yeah, like mother, like daughter, Ruby. She'd be a demon that helps me start the apocalypse. If she loved it, I guess I'd be proud. Yeah. Thank you. Nice to meet you.
First of all, it's my first time at a convention, and I wanted to say thank you. Thank you so much for everything that you do, that you have done, that you are doing, and what you're planning to do. You are such not only an amazingly talented actor, but also an incredible human being. I'm very happy and grateful to be able to be here and to tell this to you. Now my question is about Sam. When we first met him in the pilot, he is not really keen on getting back to hunting with Dean, because he has this dream of going to law school and becoming a lawyer. So you know Sam better than anyone in the world, so the question is, do you think 15 years later, after Dean died, this dream was still relevant and he wanted to fulfill it, or everything was different for him at the time?
Great question. In my head, having filmed it, Sam didn't go back to law school. Sam had realized that there was more to do. I think part of where Sam was in the pilot, and even during season one when he just wanted to find Dad and get, he was kind of denying, and it's a pretty classic trope, like denying your destiny. You know, like Luke Skywalker doesn't want to be a Jedi. He doesn't want to face Darth Vader and Emperor Palpatine. Harry Potter doesn't want to be the chosen one who has to fight Voldemort. Like it's a great storyline of someone going like, I don't want to do this, and then realizing they're called to action, they're called to adventure. And so in my head, Sam did not go back to law school. He kind of, in my head, that's not what Dean wanted for him, you know? And Dean had given his life for Sam, and Sam gave his life for Dean a few times too. Luckily, he was resurrected, more often than not. So I think Sam just tried to honor his brother's wishes and fucking pat himself on the back for a sec. I'm like, I've done my bit, you know? Like, I've sacrificed enough, and my brother's gone, I'm gonna try and live a happy life. That's what Dean would have wanted. So that's my answer.
Thank you so much.
Hi, Barry.
This is actually a weird question, but I'll just ask it. I'm a dance teacher, so I know a lot about flexibility.
Anesthesiologist?
I'm a dance teacher.
Oh, I got it.
And so I know a lot about flexibility. Same. And mobility. And yesterday during your panel, I was so surprised about your sitting position in this chair with your back on this 90-degree angle.
Oh,
your chair
like this?
Back was just, more like that. And I was asking, wondering the whole time, are you doing anything for your mobility or doing any sports to get that?
Thank you for noticing. I'm sure I'm not as flexible as you are, but I do think stretching is important, and I've just always been kind of a, like, you know what Gumby is? Like, just my limbs everywhere. I try to keep mobile. We've all seen the show. I went through years when I was in my 20s and 30s, where I was like, I want to get super strong, and you lose mobility, everything hurts. And so I think now in my 40s with wife and kids, sort of like, I just want to be able to move around and not be in pain. So I do stretch. I stretch all the time, actually. I've got a pretty good, I think this isn't lateral, my linear, I guess, flexibility, like I could probably kick that door frame. I've got a pretty good little high kick. I'm not going to do it right now. I can't. Broken toe, so if I try and do it, that's gonna hurt it more. But no, thank you for noticing. If you have any stretching tips, write them down, I'll take them. Yeah, I mean it. Yeah, write it down. I'll see you later.
Yeah, okay.
Thanks a bunch.
Thank you.
I'm Zoysia Ankerhoven. My question is about Cordell.
Okay.
If he was in the supernatural world, would he have made a demon deal or something to save Emily or someone else?
Oh, totally. It's hard being a single dad. Yeah, amazing. Hey, oh, shoot. That's actually a really good question. Fudge. No, I don't think he would have, actually. I think Sam's more likely, and Sam did try to make a demon deal. I think Cordell is kind of bound by what he thinks is the ultimate right decision. Interesting. That's a weird, that's a great question. I haven't considered that. You know, maybe when we bring Supernatural back, I'll be Sam and some sense. I've already done that. It'll be flannel versus cowboy hat. Cordell will be taller because I wear cowboy boots. So I'll be like, what's up, shorty? But yeah, that's a great question. I'm going to think about that. Thank you. Good to see you. Where in Poland?
Poznan.
Oh, we were in Poznan for the USO tour. Yeah, beautiful. Yeah, it was great. We were only there for a day, but for a great time. Yeah, funny. I love that I've been there. Yeah, thank you. What's your last name? How would you say my last name? And
in Polish?
Yeah.
Padalecki.
That's what I've been told. Yeah. Cool. I like it. Thank you.
Hi. I'm Larissa. I'm from the Netherlands. I gave you the story about this yesterday. My question is, what's your dumbest way you ever injured yourself?
What? Shit. How long ago? There's so many answers to this. Too many. Just because it's on my mind, speaking of dogs, I was playing with my dog on Monday or Tuesday, I forget which day, just this past week. And my kids had like soccer balls and footballs in the yard, and my dog had bit this soccer ball and punctured it, and so it's flat, but it floats in the pool. And so the kids were in school, Jim is somewhere, friends are meeting or something, it's midday, so I get in the pool, and I was playing with the soccer ball in the pool to get Coda, my shepherd, to swim. And so it was kind of floating in the middle of the pool, and I was like, get him one, come on, get it. And he jumps in, he starts swimming towards it, and I go to get to it first, and I go to like kick off the bottom of the pool, and it wasn't as deep as I thought it was. And so I jammed my foot, like my toe, like as hard as I could, yeah. And I screech in pain, and Coda's like swimming from the soccer ball. I'm like, fudge, but I didn't say fudge. I'm like, God, and he's like, looks over, and he's like, do you not want me to get it? And then the next morning is just black and blue, and I just, oh, I also broke my pinky toe. Can you call the pinky toe? January 1st, watching a football game, I just kicked a coffee table. Yeah, I need like a padded room. They're like, are you insane? I'm like, kind of, but really I'm just accident prone. And I'm getting older. But yeah, just because that's the most recent dumb thing I've done to myself. Thank you. Good to see you again. Thank you. I also injured myself marathoning, which I think you can vouch for.
Well, I'm Leah from Germany, and my question is, from your past projects, like besides Supernatural, is there someone you would like to work with again, like any actor or like director or writer or someone? Or is there someone you haven't been able to work with yet, but would like to?
Yeah, great question. A lot. Trying to go outside of Supernatural, because there's so many. I have a really soft spot in my heart, both as a friend, and we still keep in touch, and I've talked about work together, and just as an actor, my friend Milo Ventimiglia, he's awesome, he's an incredible actor, and a great guy. Yeah. Yeah. And early on in my career, when he was Jess and I was Dean, the original Dean, he kind of I was a 17-year-old kid from San Antonio. Like, my mom was a teacher, my dad was an accountant. I didn't know anything about Hollywood. I didn't know anything about what you're supposed to do with your clothes and what you're allowed to do for lunch and what you're, like, where you can go, where you can't. And he just kind of showed me around. He was like, hey, let me take you over here. Hey, and our characters were rivals, you know? So they'd call cut, he'd be like, hey, you want to go to lunch? Like, are we allowed to? He's like, yeah. He's like, oh, you sure, you know? So great, dude. He pops to my head. I mean, so many people I've worked with, been fortunate enough to work with, had a great time with. Yeah, God, the list goes on, but I'll stick with Milo for now. Yeah. Thank you. Hello.
I'm Africa from Spain.
Africa from Spain? Yeah. Is your name really Africa?
Yes, that's
amazing.
Yes, that's funny.
Oh my God, now we need someone named Spain from Africa.
Yeah.
Find it.
Well, first of all, I want to thank you for everything because you do so much. And my question is, what is your go-to song or music when you're feeling anxious or overwhelmed or having a, you know, or dealing with anxiety?
Yeah, it depends, because sometimes I get active with anxiety. Like, if I'm feeling really anxious, I'll go for a walk or go, like, I'm sure some of y'all have seen my knuckles are all bloody. I have a heavy bag at home, and I was kind of feeling anxious about the end of season and this and that, so I put gloves on. But I went out and I was in my bag and I busted my knuckle and then this knuckle. I'm fine, I have a little cut, blister or whatever. So there are certain songs for that. I'll do this. I don't know who the artist's name was. I saw it on like an Instagram ad, possibly for like a place in Spain. It's called, it's my alarm clock. And I like waking up feeling peaceful or trying to. It's called Idea One by Gibran Alcocer, A-L-C-O-C-E-R. And it's just piano. Yeah. It's a nice way to wake up. Wipe the drool off my face. Figure out why all the pillows are on the ground everywhere. Yeah. Idea One, Gibran, like, G-I-B-R-A-N, Alcocer, A-L-C-O-C-E-R. It kind of puts me in a peaceful mood, you know? It's great on a plane, too, for those who flew here. Like, when you take it off and you're looking out at the sky, and like, oh, bye, ground. It's peaceful. So, yeah, recently that's up.
Thank you.
Do you have one? Do you have one or more that you listen to?
Yes, I mean, I have a song from Radio Company, actually.
Yeah.
And City Grow Willow. Wow.
Thank you, Africa from Spain. That's amazing. I want to change my name now. How are you?
How are you?
Wonderful, thank you.
Since I'm from Italy, we are in Italy, I wanted to know which city in Italy that you visited was your favorite?
Oh, wow. So I love Italy. Jen's grandparents are from Italy. And we're like any day from getting our Italian passport. We're just waiting for the consulate to come. So I'm moving here. God, so many. For my 40th birthday, Jen and I, and my brother and his wife, went to the Dolomites. I can't recall the city's names because we went hiking. And it was beautiful. How do you choose a city in Italy? Every city in Italy. I've only been on the West Coast. You know what? I love Rome. Rome is daunting, you know? It's so massive. It's more difficult for me to kind of grasp. It's amazing, the history. Firenze? Yeah. I love it there. I love the city center where you can't drive cars, so you walk around to the Duomo.
I'm from Tuscany, so.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, amazing. Yeah. Lucca, also.
Yes, that's half an hour from my city.
So. Oh, I love it. What's your city called?
Pisa.
Oh.
I know you were.
I went to Pisa, yeah. I did the stupid tourist picture. Like, no one's ever done this before. And you look online, you look up Pisa, and every freaking person is like, look at me, I'm holding up the tower. Beautiful, yeah, awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you. We have, okay, one last. One last, please.
Hi, I'm Spain from Africa.
Yes, I love you! No shit, you'll never believe this. So a second ago...
Claudia from Germany.
Still cool.
And I wanted to ask, as a father, what is the most important thing you want to teach your kids?
Wow. Thank you. I've thought about this, and I've talked about this with friends, with Genevieve, obviously a lot. There are two things, and I'll put them in order. They're close, you know, number one, number two are super close. Hopefully both. Kindness and curiosity.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I think it comes, thank you. I think those two things kind of encompass everything else. Like, and the curiosity also, like, I'm a very curious person. I think it's led to my biggest blessings. But also, if you're curious, you're not judgmental. It's not like, hey, this person did this. It's like, I wonder why this person did that. So you're just curious to know somebody's story as opposed to like, well, the fucking guy cut me off. It's like, well, maybe he's gonna rush to the hospital with his kid or something. Maybe he's gonna lose his job if he's late to work and they had a flat tire and he got off to it. So you don't, it keeps me peaceful, like remaining curious. Like when I get a kind of angry or anxious feeling, it's like, why am I anxious right now? What am I worried about? Oh, the season's ending. I don't know if we're picked up yet. My wife and I'll be fine, but I have crew members I care about that, you know, I don't want that to search for another job or, so I, yeah, I'll just, and kindness is obvious, but I'd say kindness and curiosity.
And curiosity leads to knowledge, so.
There you go, ideally, yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you all so much. Love you all. Love you all, curious about y'all. Nice to see you guys.